we have learnt about what is speed. Now in this topic we are going to learn what is velocity, different kinds of velocity and what are the important formulas for it we are going to know, and the units also we are going to know. Now what is velocity? Similar to the speed, velocity is the rate of change of displacement. Velocity is the rate of change of displacement. Velocity is the rate of change of displacement. The mathematical expression for the velocity is velocity is equals to displacement by time t. Or else we can write it as rate of change of displacement. And it is a vector quantity. It has both magnitude and direction. Now we are going to see the dimensional formula for velocity. We all know that velocity means displacement by time. Displacement dimensional formula is L. Time dimensional formula is T. So the dimensional formula for velocity is L t power minus 1. Next. Now we are going to see the units. Serious unit is same as the speed, meter per second, centimeter per second. SI unit is meter per second. And the generally used unit is kilometer per hour. Now the types of velocity which we are going to see here is uniform velocity, non-uniform velocity, and average velocity. Now coming to the first one, uniform velocity. If a body moves equal displacements in equal intervals of time, we can say that the body is moving with uniform velocity. Or else we can also say that if a body covers equal distances in equal intervals of time in the same direction, here we have to mention the same direction because whenever we are traveling in the same direction, displacement and distance will be equal. So it will be the uniform velocity. If a body covers equal displacements in equal intervals of time, then the body is moving with uniform velocity. Now, non-uniform velocity. Like same as the non-uniform speed, here also we can say if a body covers unequal displacements in equal intervals of time, then we can say that the body is moving with non-uniform velocity. If a body covers unequal displacements in equal intervals of time,
can say that. The body is moving with non-uniform velocity.
Now coming to average velocity. Now when the average velocity comes into picture, whenever the body is moving with non-uniform velocity, then only we can observe the average velocity. Average velocity, it is nothing but the total displacement covered by total time taken.
Total displacement covered by total time taken.
And one more thing is here, the velocity can be negative, positive and zero. But whereas the speed cannot be negative, ratio. Now the ratio of average speed and average velocity is always greater than or equal to 1. And its magnitude is always greater than or equal to 1. Now we are going to see one more term, that is instantaneous velocity. Instantaneous velocity means, let us suppose the body is moving on a road. Now if you want to find out its velocity at a particular point of time, we have to take the instantaneous velocity. We have to consider the instantaneous velocity at that particular point of time. If we calculate the velocity, then it is said to be instantaneous velocity.
The velocity of a body moving at a particular instant is called instantaneous velocity.
Now, in the previous topic speed, I have already given some graphs related to the motion of a body. Now here I am going to give some graphs which are related to the topic uniform speed, different types of speed. Now here the first graph, this is the graph between time and displacement. It is a straight line passing through origin. So we can say that the body here is moving with uniform velocity. Now considering the second graph. Now here the graph is parallel to x-axis or time axis. So we can say that it is not displacing with respect to time. So we can say that the body is at rest. Now here in this third graph we are having different lines. Three lines we have here. 1, 2, 3. They are all having different slopes. Okay. So we can say that the body is moving with non-uniform velocity. The body here is moving with non-uniform velocity. Now this is all about the topic what we have learned today, and this is velocity and different kinds of velocity, dimensional formula, units and average velocity, and how the ratio will be, and how the graphs of different types of velocities will be, we have seen in this video. Thank you.